Good evening, I'm Hamid Shaban, and this is the 11 o'clock news from Bahrain International. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received a phone call from the custodian of the two holy mosques, King Salman bin Abdul Aziz Al Saud, to congratulate him on the successful medical checkups he had undergone recently. He wished the Prime Minister abundant health to continue the kingdom's development march. His Royal Highness expressed appreciation to the Saudi monarch's noble gesture, which reflects the solid relations between the two countries. He affirmed that the custodian of the two holy mosques' congratulations is one of the many honorable stances in support of the kingdom. His Royal Highness wished Saudi Arabia further security and stability to continue its leading role in the regional and international levels. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received a phone call from His Royal Highness Prince Talal bin Abdul Aziz Al Saud congratulating him on the success of his medical checkups. He wished the Prime Minister abundant health and happiness. His Royal Highness expressed appreciation to Prince Talal's noble gesture, which reflects the solid relations between the two brotherly countries. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa held a telephone call with the Emir of Kuwait, His Highness Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah, in which he thanked him for his noble gesture that reflects the solid relations bonding the two nations. His Royal Highness also held a telephone call with the Kuwaiti Crown Prince Sheikh Nawaf Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah and the Kuwaiti Prime Minister Sheikh Jaber Mubarak Al Hamad Al Sabah, in which he expressed appreciation for their congratulations on the success of his medical checkups. Under the sponsorship of His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, the first Deputy President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of the Bahrain Athletics Association, the activities of the Khalid bin Hamad Award for Graduation Projects Forum under the slogan Creating Innovation has concluded. The forum was organized by the University of Bahrain and the Media Office of His Highness Sheikh Khalid with the participation of 10 universities in the kingdom. His Highness expressed pleasure at the inventions presented by participating students from various universities, stressing that the award comes from the keenness to continue with scientific initiatives that reinforce goals of the reform project by His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa to support youth of both genders towards scientific and educational excellence. His Highness pointed out to the interest and support in the education sector by the wise leadership, which contributed to achieving the goals of the reform project, which relies on creative youth energies to continue the development process of the local market and attain the goals of Bahrain 2030 vision, which guides the youth to invest their energies on the creative and innovative output, achieving comprehensive development reforms that contribute to the advancement of the national economy, which builds a better life for Bahrain society. His Highness stressed that the Khalid bin Hamad Graduation Projects Award Forum has achieved success, pointing that this edition has many successful projects. He explained that the slogan Creating Innovation reflected Bahrain's youth abilities seen in the forum, expressing great admiration for the projects that showcased the scientific potential of Bahraini youth. Sheikh Khalid pointed to the importance of investing in these events as they are national events that refine talents of students in various fields, such as engineering and computer technology. His Highness asserted that the Graduation Projects Forum is an important station for students as it strengthens their abilities and refines their talents, which goes in line with the futuristic vision of Bahrain. He added that scientific research is important in a student's scientific march, pointing out the importance of improving it through higher education studies, which serves the Economic Vision 2030. He also stressed that establishing the Graduation Projects Forum comes from the belief in the importance of higher education, especially as scientific research would be the basis of developing the kingdom. He watched the forum's final day events, where he expressed admiration of the projects presented by the students. After the awarding ceremony, Dr. Riyadh Hamza presented His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa with a commemorative gift for sponsoring the event. His Highness thanked and appreciated all members of the higher committee, all the speakers, supervisors of the discussion panels, and all committees that worked on organizing this event. He also wished luck to all of the students who participated in the event for more future projects that will help develop Bahrain. The Minister of Education held a ceremony patronized by the Minister of Education, Dr. Majid bin Ali Naimi, celebrating Bahrain students' outstanding results in the TIMSS 2015 assessment framework in mathematics and science and the TIMSS Numeracy 2015 global test of numerical culture. During the ceremony, the minister honored students, teachers, and schools that have excelled in the tests, as well as the ministry's supervisory team, in appreciation for their contribution to Bahrain's achieving first place in the Arab world in the science test and second place in the mathematics test. Bahrain also had the highest rate of development in the mathematics field globally, with a high student achievement rate of 45 points. He also noted that Bahrain achieved first place in the TIMSS Numeracy 2015 test. The minister expressed pride in this global accomplishment and stressed that it would not have been possible without the support of the wise leadership that played vital importance on education as a top priority. Information Affairs Minister Ali Al-Ramehi participated in the 11th Islamic Conference of Information Ministers, which was held in the Saudi city of Jeddah for 2 days under the theme New Media to Counter Terrorism and Islamophobia. Addressing the gathering, the minister reiterated Bahrain's keenness to confront provocative discourse, which incites hatred and in the light of the threats that face the nation. He also noted the grave challenges targeting the Islamic nation, its unity, security, identity and progress. He underlined the need to bolster ties of fraternity and integration under the Organization of Islamic cooperation on the basis of responsibility and mutual respect and the sovereignty amongst member states. He called on adopting innovative methods to enhance the role of national mass media in facing campaigns against Islam and Muslims. The minister underlined the need to back joint media projects given the pivotal role of the media in promoting common understanding between Islamic countries. He also called to follow up on the OIC's media strategy to confront Islamophobia and endorse a binding Islamic media code of conduct to incriminate discourse of extremism, hatred, and terrorism. The minister emphasized the need to take the necessary legal and technical procedures to stop the broadcasting of satellite channels, inciting sectarianism and hatred, and preventing misuse of modern technologies as platform for cybercrimes. Al-Ramehi went on to hail the efforts of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia in serving Islam and Muslims, as well as protecting sacred lands. He praised the role of the Saudi-led Arab and Islamic alliance in fighting extremism and terrorism. He also voiced strong condemnation of the terror attacks on Mecca by the Houthi terrorist militias in Yemen, describing it as a grave escalation breaching all religion, humanitarian and ethical principles. The minister pointed out the sectarian-motivated terror acts in many Arab and Islamic countries, stressing the need to preserve moderation and fight advocates of terrorism. Al-Ramehi wished the session every success in coming up with resolutions that serve common goals of fostering Islamic media cooperation and achieving the supreme interests of the Islamic nation and promoting peace, stability and sustainable development.